गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, एम आई ऑडिबल?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके सो क्लास, लेट मी जस्ट गिव यू सम वन इंफॉर्मेशन दैट आई एम सागर वासने फ्रॉम मैनेजमेंट डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे आई विल टेक केयर ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। यह नीरज सर इज नॉट अवेलेबल, सो आई विल टेक केयर ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। Okay, so today we will discuss about the organizational change. Clear? So first of all, I want to be know that whether am I audible or to everyone or not.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Your voice is.
Okay, thank you. One more thing, those who are not connected with their voice audio, so please connect with your audio. There are a lot of students I can. Connected with their audio, so please connect it with your audio. Clear. So today we will discuss about the organization change. So can anyone just tell me what do you mean by the term organizational change? Anyone who just want to be just tell.
Sir, can you repeat your question, please?
I want to know what do you mean by the term organizational change?
Sir, a change which is made in any type of organization.
Okay.
For which the whole organization that will affect the whole organization.
Okay. So you are talking about the change by which any organization faces any new things.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I want to be know about that change. Clear? Organization change, sir. It is okay. Your organization change ye hota hai. But what do you think it change kya hota hai?
When we make differences in our previous way of work and the new way of work.
Okay.
And it can be work, schedule, routine, anything. When we make some differences, then it called change.
Okay. So I think we get the things. Change is about whether we are modifying, whether we are transforming, whether we are updating the things. Yes, all these things means the change. Change is not a very smaller aspect. It is a very big aspect. Here, when we talk about the change, so it means that we are just making any kind of transformation, modification, updation, or we are just transferring one people from another. Like today, I'm just taking a lecture on the behalf of Neeraj sir. So this is also a change. Clear? So change is all about whether we are just shifting one thing to the another. Clear? So it is a change when we talk about the organizational change. So organizational change is all about a modification or transformation. Clear? Or updation of the various organizational aspects. Whether it is technology, whether it is manpower, whether it is organization structure, whether it is organization policy. So modification, transformation or updation in the organization structure, process or technology, in policies or goods. For what? For better future growth or for better future profit. So this is the main things by which organization always just opt out for the organizational change. Clear? So it is you can take an example of any organization. Clear? Agar main baat karun ki jo Maggi hai, theek hai, Maggi ka product ham crisis hua tha, unke sath crisis hua tha some time ago, ki jab unke brand mein kuch yani ki kuch cheeze paayi gayi thi, to uske baad kya hua that unki brand ke liye ek tarike se pura hi destroy ho chuka tha. So what they do, they change their goods. ठीक है, उन्होंने अपने गुड्स में चेंज किया क्योंकि उनके गुड्स में लैड पाया गया था. तो इसके थ्रू क्या हुआ, दे अडॉप्टेड सम चेंज इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड देन दे जस्ट इन्वॉल्व इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन चेंज प्रोसेस. क्लियर? सो दिस इज वन एग्जांपल. ठीक है, जो मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ कि चेंज किस किस तरीके से हो सकता है. क्लियर? एक और एग्जाम्पल है, जैसे कि पहले हमारे सिनेमाज होते थे, ठीक है, मूवी सिनेमा,
तो मूवी सिनेमा में क्या होता था कि मूवी सिनेमा जो थे वहां पे प्रीवियसली लोग आते थे, बैठते थे थिएटर में और देख के चले जाते थे, ठीक है। और वो सिंपल सी चेयर होती थी, ना कोई 3D होता था ना कोई स्टूडियो होता था। बट जैसे जैसे टेक्नोलॉजी आती गई, वैसे वैसे जो सिनेमा हॉल हैं वो चेंज होते गए, किसमें? मल्टीप्लेक्स में, क्लियर। सो इट इज ऑल्सो अ प्रोसेस ऑफ चेंज वेयर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेटिंग सम न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी इन द सिस्टम बाय विच दे मेक देयर कस्टमर मोर इंटरेस्टेड टूवर्ड द ब्रांड। सो इट इज अ थिंग बाय विच ऑलवेज कंपनी जस्ट गो फॉर द चेंज, ठीक है। हम जब चेंज की बात कर रहे हैं, सो चेंज इज नॉट अ वन टाइम प्रोसेस, दैट यू ऑल नो कि चेंज इज अ लॉन्ग टर्म और कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस इन विच दे ऑलवेज मॉडिफाई, ट्रांसफॉर्म और अपडेट देयर टेक्नोलॉजिकल एस्पेक्ट टू फॉर वॉट, फॉर जस्ट अट्रैक्टिंग न्यू कस्टमर, फॉर द फ्यूचर ग्रोथ, फॉर द मेकिंग मोर प्रॉफिट। सो जो चेंज है, चेंज इज द लॉ ऑफ नेचर, क्लियर। सो दैट चेंज यू ऑल्सो नीड टू बी अडोप्टेड। इट इज नॉट अ थिंग कि आप खुद ही चेंज खुद लेके यानी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में ही ला रहे हो, नो। यू ऑल्सो नीड टू बी टेक सम चेंजेस इन योर सेल्फ, क्लियर। सपोज आफ्टर वन और टू ईयर यू वेन यू विल जस्ट फेसेस द इंटरव्यूज, तो वहां पे क्या होगा, यू हैव टू बी जस्ट अपडेटेड योर सेल्फ। आपको अपने आप को अपडेटेड करना होगा एंड यू हैव टू बी जस्ट अडॉप्टेड न्यू स्किल्स बाय विच द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल हायर यू। सो दैट चेंज इज अ लॉ ऑफ नेचर एंड एवरीवन हैव टू बी जस्ट गो फॉर द चेंज, क्लियर। सो दिस इज यानी कि मेरी तरफ से ऑर्गेनाइजेशन चेंज था, क्लियर। अगर किसी को कुछ पूछना हो इसके रिगार्डिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन चेंज, या फिर जस्ट आई वांट टू बी आस्क वन क्वेश्चन कि कैन एनीवन जस्ट टेल मी जिसने चेंज अडॉप्ट ना किया हो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने और वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फेल हो गया हो, किसी को ऐसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का नाम पता है?
बजाज।
आस्था नहीं, किसने बोला था ये?
शुभांशी ने।
हाँ शुभांशी, क्या बोला था? आपकी आवाज क्लियर नहीं थी
सर। बजाज।
ओके बजाज। एनीवन एल्स, और कोई कुछ बताना चाहेगा किसी ब्रांड का नेम? बहुत कॉमन ब्रांड थी, बहुत यूज होती थी
सर। नोकिया।
यस नोकिया, नोकिया वाज द ब्रांड, ठीक है। इन 2010 के आसपास व्हेन स्मार्टफोन वाज लॉन्च इन इंडिया, तो क्या हुआ था कि जो जो नोकिया था उसने रजिस्टर किया था चेंज के लिए। उन्होंने अपने जो प्रोडक्ट एग्जिस्टिंग प्रोडक्ट था उसमें कोई भी चेंज नहीं लेके आए थे। उसमें उन्होंने क्या किया था कि हम जो प्रीवियस प्रोडक्ट है हमारा, हम उसी के साथ चलेंगे, हम कीप इट मोबाइल पब्लिक को देंगे। एंड व्हाई दे आर जस्ट गोइंग फॉर दैट, बिकॉज दे थिंक्स कि दे आर द लीडर इन द ऑटोमोबाइल मार्केट, सॉरी इन द मोबाइल हैंडसेट मार्केट, तो वो कुछ भी करेंगे तो जो पीपल है वो उसको अडॉप्ट करेगा। नो, बट आफ्टर उसके जब स्मार्टफोन इंट्रोड्यूस हुए और उसके बाद सैमसंग था जिसने अपॉर्चुनिटी ग्रैब की, और सैमसंग ने सबसे पहले मोबाइल लॉन्च किए, और उसके बाद सैमसंग एक तरीके से लीडर बन गया इंडियन मार्केट में आफ्टर हम कह सकते हैं नोकिया। तो नोकिया के क्या हुआ, नोकिया रजिस्टर टू चेंज, और जब उसने रजिस्टर टू चेंज किया, क्लियर, सो उसके साथ ही उसकी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एक साथ फेल हो गई। एंड नाउ यू कैन यू नो व्हाट हाउ इज द नोकिया जस्ट गोइंग ऑन राइट नाउ, ठीक है। ही जस्ट वेंट सोल्ड टू द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एंड माइक्रोसॉफ्ट लॉन्चेस द नोकिया अंडर देयर ब्रांड नेम। So this is the things when you are not adopting the changes or when you are just registering the changes. So that's why organization change is very important aspect for every organization, because it take care of their profit also, their customer also, and their lot of thing also. Clear? So this is organization change. So please just go for 1 minute and let things, is it clear to everyone or not? Or then please let me know about it, whether it is clear or not. If you have any doubt, so please let me know.
So it is clear class, or do anyone have any kind of query in this? Okay. So next we will think about the organization change prospect. यानी हम उसके approaches कौन कौन से होते हैं कि organization change के दो approaches होते हैं, reactive और proactive. Clear? I think you all are just familiarized with these words, reactive and proactive. Reactive are the things when we are just reacting when the situation just happened. Clear? So this is your reaction. Clear? आप react कर रहे हो after the situation happened. When we talk about the proactive, so it is a futuristic aspect where just you analyzes the all things and just make the changes in advance by which you just take advantage of your being so futuristic. So when the organization being reactive, so in that cases the organization loses its loses its customer profit and various other aspects. But when the organization is proactive, so then they just making an advantage of being futuristic and just make it a good change in the organization by which they attract the new customer in the market and also make some profits. And it is not all about the attracting the customer and making a profit. It is also about just maintaining a good structure in organization. So it is about organization change can be just done by the two prospects. First is your reactive prospect. Second one is your proactive process. Like you can understand by one example, like Maggie tha. Maggie ne jo bhi changes kiye in their product, so that was reaction. Clear? Us situation ka reaction tha jo unhone liya. So they were reactive in that case. But there are a lot of organizations who just analyzes their all the things on a regular basis and find out if they find out any kind of problem in it. So then they make it the changes. So that is your proactive changes. So it is very good when organization just go for the proactive changes in the system, because it helps to just not ruin down their credibility in the market, also not ruin down their trust that made by the customer and the employee also. So whether we have a two approaches, reactive and proactive, but always the organization want to prefer a proactive process, proactive approach of organization change. So this is the two approaches by which organization can make changes in their system, then reactive and proactive. And next topic we will understand about in which areas, any scope of organization change. जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन चेंज है वो कहाँ कहाँ यूज हो सकता है. क्लियर? तो रिएक्टिव एंड प्रोएक्टिव में किसी को कोई क्वेरी है? क्लास okay. So next we will understand about the scope of organization change, where the organization can make their changes. The first we have in the structure of an organization. Clear? Structure means how they are just working. Clear? Organization ke kuch structure hote hain, like aapke formal channels hote hain, informal channels hota hai, aapke communication ka way hota hai, aapke organization mein designated kitne people hain. So this the all thing involve in the organizational structure. So organization change ka scope first hai that in the structure of an organization. So if they want to make any changes, like wo formal structure ko hata ke informal structure leke aana chahte hain, wo kuch designation ko organization se hatana chahte hain ya kuch designation ko add karna chahte hain, so that is all about your structure of organization. Clear? So this is the first point in structure of an organization. Next we have in organization operation, or we can say in organization size of workforce. So this is the second point. Clear? So operation activity means ke jo bhi company ke plant hote hain. Clear? Where they are producing their goods and services. So they can also make their changes in the organizational operation, whether they want to be just added some more machinery, whether they want to be added more employee in the organization. So if they are just doing these things, so that will involve, or that will count in an organizational change. Next we have in a technology. So jo technology hai, to organization us technology mein bhi कुछ चेंजेस करते रह सकते हैं. सो दिस इज द मेन पॉइंट वेयर द मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मेक देयर चेंजेस. लाइक व्हेन वी जस्ट टॉक अबाउट द वेरियस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स कंपनीज, ठीक है, सो दे आर मोस्टली यूजिंग इट्स, दे आर मेनली यूजिंग दिस चेंजेस, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन चेंज इन देयर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. लाइक कि इन एवरी आफ्टर वन मंथ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन गेट अ न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी और दे गेट अ टेक्नोलॉजिकल अपडेशन. सो इट इज वेरी जस्ट वी कैन से नॉट सिंपल फॉर एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन for make every time updation in their technology, because it is not cost efficient, because every time when an organization just go for the technological updation, so it want some time and it want also some cost. So not every time organization just bear these cost and timing aspects, but also organization make their most of the changes in the technological updation. Clear. And second, we have a work last second in the way role are carried out, means the designated people. Clear. In the designated people, the roles which are carried out by the various people. Clear. So class, we were talking about the organization's changes in scope. So we were talking about the fourth point in the way role are carried out, means the designations that are carried by various people. So it the organization also just make a changes in the role that is carried out by the various people. Like suppose one people just having the position of assistant manager. So now they can transfer to the position of manager. So it is just organization change where they are just making changes in the roles that are carried out by the various people. So transfer, promotion are also count in an organization change. And so these are the various scope of organization change. First one, the organization can make their changes in their structure. Second one, in the operation size of the workforce. Third, in the technology. And fourth, in the way roles are carried out. So these are the four organization change scopes where they can make changes. Clear? So please just go for these four. And if you have any doubt, so please let me know about it. So class, do anyone have any kind of query in the scope of organization change?
No, sir.
Okay, so I think we move ahead. Next, we are having a forces for change. Means, what are the various forces that make organizations to involve in this process? Clear? So, can anyone tell me what do you think? What are the various forces by which organizations think that they will involve in the organization change process?
Sir, didn't get your question.
The question is that, what do you think, what are the various forces? Clear? What are the various forces, hum keh sakte hai, factor that make organization for being involved in the organization change process?
Sir, sometimes the growth of other organizations, as if another organization which is in with competition with that organization, if such organization make changes in their technologies or anything else and they are growing good, then to compare with all these things, another have also changed.
Okay, so you mean simply we can say the competition.
Sometimes requirement of customer also changes.
Okay, some requirement from the side of the customer. Okay. Okay, anyone else? Anyone else who want to be just speak on it? So I think the other log process mein involved nahi hona chahte. So okay, so when we comes to know about the various forces, or we can say the factors for which that these factors just forcing organization for just making a change in the system. So in this, we categorize these forces in two part. We are just categorizing these things in a two part. First, we have a internal forces. Second, we have a external forces. Internal forces ka matlab hota hai, these forces which are stating the organization will go for the change. These are only involved. These factor only present in the boundaries of the organization. जो कंपनी की बाउंड्रीज होती हैं, तो ये जो सारे फैक्टर्स होते हैं वो उन बाउंड्रीज में ही इन्वॉल्व होते हैं. क्लियर? सो लाइक इफ वी टॉक अबाउट इट, द क्राइसिस इन विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जस्ट इन्वॉल्व आउट. लाइक अगर मैंने आपको बताया था जो मैगी के साथ क्राइसिस हुआ था, ठीक है, सैमसंग के साथ भी क्राइसिस हुआ था कि उनके मोबाइल फोन ब्लास्ट होना स्टार्ट हो गए थे. सो दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ क्राइसिस जो कहते हैं कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैव टू बी जस्ट मेक सम चेंजेस इन देयर गुड्स. Clear? Or most of the time, एक क्राइसिस हुआ था, I think you when you all just हम कहें जो टाटा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है उसमें जो सीईओ थे साइरस मिस्त्री और जो रतन टाटा, उनके बीच में जो केसेस हुआ था, so that is also involved in the crisis kind of activity that affect the working of organization. So these are the various internal forces that just forces the organization so to make some modification, updation or transformation in the organization. So these crises are very, we can say, important, or we can say very important for organization for what? For handle out very smoothly. So these are the first point of internal forces is crisis. Second one is the employees. Clear? Many of the time all employees also forcing organization to make their changes. Like employee are not working efficiently or unke number of people hai wo bhi sahi nahi hai, so uske liye organization bhi apne system mein change leke aana chahegi. So this is the second point. Third, we are having a work climate or environment. Clear? Jo organization ki environmental condition hai aur jo hum keh sakte hain wahan ka work climate hai. So if the organization find out there are too much of politics used in the system and that are affecting the climate and environment of organization, so that point of time also organization need to make some changes in their organization. And next, we are having a deficiency in existing system. Jo organization ka existing system hai jisme organization kaam kar raha hai, means organization production kar raha hai, organization jo selling एक्टिविटी लेके आ रहा है, जो उनके प्रमोशनल एस्पेक्ट है कि एडवर्टाइजमेंट करते हैं या पर्सनल सेलिंग करते हैं, सो दीज ऑल दीज थिंग्स आल्सो जस्ट वी कैन से इन्वॉल्व इन द एग्जिस्टिंग सिस्टम. सो इफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फाइंड आउट एनी डेफिशिएंसी इन एग्जिस्टिंग सिस्टम, So organization also makes some changes in the system. Clear? So these are the four forces जो हमने categorize किए थे internal forces में, and these are your prices. Second one is your employee. Third one is your work climate environment. And fourth one is deficiency in existing system. So these are the four internal forces that make organizations for going for the change. Clear? So please class just go for it. यानी इन चार फोर्सेस को समझे और इफ यू नॉट गेट इट सो प्लीज लेट मी नो अबाउट इट.
ओके सर.
Clear class. So these are the various internal forces, and next we are having a external forces by which we just completing this external forces. We just ended with the today session. The first external forces is your technology. Clear. So technology, as you know, this is the biggest factor that make organization for involving in the change process. So technology updation is a very important for every organization because you can take example of Nokia. Nokia ने अपना technological updation नहीं किया था जो अपने goods में, तो उसकी वजह से उन्हें market से wipe out होना पड़ा था. So that technology is the biggest things जो organization को force करती है for involving in the change process. Next we are having a globalization. Clear? Globalization, I think globalization का मतलब होता है जब कोई भी company किसी दूसरी country में जाके freely अपना बिजनेस ऑपरेट कर सकती हो. सो दैट ऑल्सो मेक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर टेक सम चेंजेस इन द सिस्टम बिकॉज व्हेन यू जस्ट गो फॉर द अनदर कंट्री तो वहां पे आपको उनके रूल्स के अकॉर्डिंग ही काम करना होगा. सो दैट इज योर ग्लोबलाइजेशन. ठीक है, उसके उसके बिहाफ पे भी आपको चेंजेस करने होते हैं. एंड लास्ट वन वी आर हैविंग अ सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल चेंजेस. सोशल चेंजेस का मतलब है कि कुछ चीजें जो सोसाइटी को अनएक्सेप्टेबल लगती हैं. So then you have to be just go for the make some changes in the system. Like you can take an example कि कोई भी organization है, ठीक है, तो उनको ठीक है society में सब लोग रह रहे हैं, ठीक है, उन्होंने कुछ भी तरीके का advertisement float किया और उस advertisement ने क्या किया, they affect the sentiment of some people. तो उसकी वजह से अगर society में उनके ad की वजह से कुछ भी effect हो रहा है, so then they have to be make some changes in their system. This is your social change. And last we have a political change. Political change का मतलब होता है when the political system of an organization, due to that, if you are making any changes, so then the political change comes in the picture. Clear? So these are the various external forces
that forcing organization for involve in the change process. So if anyone have any kind of doubt in it, so please let me know. Agar nahi hai, to hum session ko yahi end kar sakte hain.
No sir,
कोई doubt नहीं है। Sir, PDF कब देंगे?
इसके लिए please आप नीरज सर से contact कर लीजिएगा। Okay, so thank you everyone, thank you class, have a nice day class.
Thank you.